Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a non-profit, non-denominational, religious, and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of His eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity until this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Tinley, in the state of Ohio in the year of 1931. We were incorporated into the state of California in the year of 1958. Since that time, we have established branch schools throughout the United States and Canada and certain foreign countries. The Ontario branch was established in May of 1988. Now, in this school, we teach by the true and correct names and title for the Father, the Word, our Son, and the Holy Spirit, as contained in the original Hebrew text. The true and correct name for the Father is Yahweh. It had been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title for the Word, our Son, is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted by God. The name of the Holy Spirit, manifest in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been improperly substituted by Jesus Christ. Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8:5, that there are Lord's many and God's many. But we now know each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title. But unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means that Elohim is a title that our Creator chose for Himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part into a good dictionary or encyclopedia will prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any letters or characters in their alphabet that will produce the sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there letter J in the English language until some 1400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings for the true and correct name of our Father and His Son. Christ is a title, just like Lord and God. Now, Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, He is inscrutable and incomprehensible and indiscernible. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of all things. We have Yahweh in His pure spirit state, symbolized on this chart as a fiery cloud. Yahweh in pure spirit is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize Himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. Just as you see, this fiery cloud has been drawn to extend all around the edge of this chart to show you that everything on this chart abides within this cloud. In like manner, everything in the creation and the sum total of the universe abides within this pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man cannot perceive of Him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and form within Himself as Elohim. This is the Word, our Son, a super incorporeal being, that is, having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. This form can only be seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this selfsame spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now, there's only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. So the simple yet intelligent question we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface to the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, he called Moses atop Mount Sinai and showed him the tabernacle pattern in a vision. He instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. This pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court roundabout. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. We go forth in this school to show proof how that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. The primary constitutional aims and objectives of the Institute are as follows. First, is to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and actually exists. Second, is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of race or nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third, is to investigate the unexplained spirit law of the so-called laws of nature and the powers latent in man. Fourth, is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religions, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Fifth, is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Six, is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. Seven, is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. Eighth, is to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered unto the sons or children of Yahweh. Ninth, is to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And tenth, is to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah, with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth. We'll have a prayer this morning by Dr. Lloyd Lawless in a scripture lesson of Matthew, the second chapter, by Dr. Ethan Williams.
Good morning, class.
Good morning.
Let us bow our hearts and mind in prayer. Heavenly Father Yahweh, we gather ourselves here once again to learn more about your purpose and plan of salvation. We hope that those that are with us here and those that are abroad and those that are still searching for the truth, make it possible, Father, for them to hear that voice that was crying in the wilderness and learn this teaching. We know that we are of Yahweh, And we know that the whole world lieth in wickedness, which makes us more grateful than ever to be part of something that's real, original, and genuine, and speaking the truth.
Hallelujah.
All these things we ask in your only begotten Son's name, Yahshua Messiah, let us all say.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
I will be reading from the Holy Name Bible, containing the Holy Name version of the Old and New Testaments, critically compared with ancient authorities and various manuscripts, provided by the late A.B. Trainer. And I'll be reading Matthew, the second chapter. Now when Yahshua was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came Magi from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where the Messiah should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, art not the least among the cities of Judea, for out of thee shall he come forth unto me, that shall rule my people Israel." Then Herod, when he hath privately called the Magi, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, and said, "Go, and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they came into the house, they saw the young child with Miriam, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened her treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of Yahweh in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of Yahweh appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him." When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night, and departed into Egypt, and was there until the death of Herod, in fulfillment of that which was spoken of Yahweh by the prophet, saying, "Out of Egypt have I called my son." Then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked by the Magi, was exceeding wroth, and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem, and in all the coasts thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the Magi. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, "In Ramah was there a voice heard, lamentation and weeping and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children, and would not be comforted because they are no more. But when Herod was dead, behold, an angel of Yahweh appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, saying, Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and go into the land of Israel, for they are dead which sought the young child's life. And he arose, and took the young child and his mother, and came into the land of Israel. But when he heard that
Archelaus
did reign in Judea in the place of his father, Herod, he was afraid to go hither. Notwithstanding being warned by Yahweh in a dream, he turned aside into the parts of Galilee, and he came and dwelt in a city of Nazareth, in fulfillment of that which was spoken by the prophets, that he should be called a Nazarene. That was Matthew, the second chapter.
I would like to have a two-speaker format this morning, and our first speaker this morning will be Dr. Ahimsa Abeg.
Greetings in the name of King Yahshua, and good morning.
Good morning.
Walk around here with the,
Yes, sir.
Walking around here with goose pimples, sitting in the seat listening to even the meeting, I got goose pimples. Keep this short because we're going to have two speaker forum, which I love. This is a school and it's not a church. Now you hear that all the time. How many been to church? Is this like that when you went?
No.
Right there. Okay. It's proof that this is a school and it's not a church. Why? Because this is a place you come to learn.
Yeah.
You understand? Yahshua said in Matthew 11:27, come learn of me. You understand? So that's why this is a school. It's a school of the highest learning. And June 6th, Saturday morning, 1931 in Springfield, Ohio, a man was caused to be held, as we say, a beautiful divine vision and revelation by the name of Henry Clifford Kinley, who came and told us what? Don't take my word for it, right? But make me prove it to you satisfied. Somebody should be satisfied by now. I know I am. To tell you the truth, I remember sitting in a house meeting back in 1980 when I first heard this thing, and I was satisfied. Yeah, I didn't understand nothing, but for some reason I felt satisfied. I felt my journey was over. Okay, it was done with. Now what you see before you pictorially illustrated is a result of the divine vision and revelation that Dr. Kinley had. And in this class, there's nowhere you can't hardly look except for the ceiling. That's why I said put it up there where there is no vision. You understand? This shows you that this is a school, and these people, brethren, want you to know Yahweh as he really is and actually exists. We did not come down here for each other. You understand what I'm saying? This is not a popularity contest. You come to learn everything you know. Give me 2 Corinthians 13:5. I don't want to say something that I can't prove, but it's not in the book. Could you open your mouth? It's on you.
2 Corinthians 13:5.
Read.
Examine yourself.
Wait a minute. This is the Apostle Paul, also known as Saul, right?
Right.
And if you've done any research, what we beg you to do, do your own research. Mm-hmm. When somebody gives you something that's beautiful, research that too. Mm-hmm. Don't just take it as it's true. Prove it to yourself. That's why we're learning to do what? Read that again, please, sir.
Examine yourself.
To examine yourself, not each other. Yourself. Because I found out with my hard head, by examining myself, I do well. It's when I get off in your business, or I'm sitting here waiting for you to make a mistake so I can jump on it. See, according to this pattern, that's fleshly.
That's right.
That's carnal.
That's right.
That's natural. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Our citizenship, according to the scriptures, should be where?
In heaven.
In heaven. Yeah. Not here. Okay. We'll be in the world, but not of it. Yeah. Read that, Dr. Horton, what I gave you. Started that yellow writing. Bear with me.
I'm reading from an introduction to the archetype and divine pattern of the universe.
Yeah, this is the old one. This is still got God in it. This is when it was at 1040, Baker's Hall.
Do you want me to keep word?
Read God. Read it as it is.
First among the requirements for securing spiritual blessings from these pages.
Now listen, you can secure spiritual blessings from the pages of what he's reading. Believe thou this, individually so. Read.
First among the requirements for securing spiritual blessings from these pages is peace of mind.
Now let's don't leave it on these pages. Because there's other pages. There's the Bible. There's a textbook. You understand? There's everything. And if you want to secure a blessing, read.
Is peace of mind.
You've got to have peace of mind. If you got all kinds of clatter up here, if you got all kinds of noises going on, hatings, envious, jealousy, malice, you are not going to hear the Heavenly Father clearly because he speaks in a small voice. And if you're full of drama, you can't hear it. And I'm speaking for me. I'm not talking about you. I'm talking what's true for me, what I've learned. Because, see, we're coming. Do you see that here? That's death.
That's right.
Yeah. We're coming from death to life.
That's right.
We use this pattern. You got seven steps in it, right? Mm-hmm. You go from death to life. Seven steps. It's seven levels, whatever you want to call it, in this tabernacle. And you can be here thinking you're here.
Yeah. That's right.
You can. You don't, because I'm impatient. I'm not waiting on no revelation. I want it now. So I go up and start interpreting what I think. And then somebody knocks me down. Because I'm giving my concept theories and opinions. And that's what Dr. Kinley said and expressed in this same pamphlet, that Yahweh is not dealing with your concepts, theories, and opinions. He's dealing with the part of us that's made in his likeness and in his image. You understand? In his likeness and his image. Read.
As when the master desired to pray, he chose a place of solitude, apart from the press of daily living, usually in the vast stillness of a mountainside. There, in the majestic grandeur of the nature which he had helped his father to create the realm of the invisible.
Now remember, wait, stop right there. What he's saying right here, happened here. Mm-hmm. But it's manifested here.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
That's correct. Mm-hmm.
There was no pattern like this in the shape and form. But it was here. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
This is a reflect of what was happening here. Mm-hmm. Okay? Read.
The materialized of Son of God stripped himself of all earthly restrictions.
Stop right there, Kenway. Give me Proverbs 8 and 20. Let's prove that too. We don't want you to think that this character just popped out the cloud. It's not like that. This is the Heavenly Father. See these attributes? Wisdom, intelligence, knowledge, love, beauty, justice, foundation, spouse. They lined up in an organized set. How you say? An organized shape and form. Known as Yahweh Elohim. This is a father. He, in other words, he got out of the creating business when he did this. This is his work clothes. Because we could not conceive of him in this state.
That's right.
Okay? So he took on this shape and form as Yahweh Elohim. And they got a beautiful thing over there. You can see him stepping through the veil. Never mind. I want to go there. Go ahead, read.
Proverbs 8 and 20. I lead in the way of righteousness.
Who leads in the way of righteousness? Ahimsa?
No.
Joe? Dr. Williams?
Nope.
Somebody got to lead in the way of righteousness. Ain't none of us? Read.
In the midst of the paths of judgment, that I may cause those that love me to inherit substance.
Now listen to these words very closely. That I who? I Yahweh Elohim, may cause those that love me to inherit what?
Substance.
Substance. Yahweh is the source.
Right.
And the
substance.
And the limits and the bounds. Yeah. And its substance is wisdom, intelligence, knowledge, love, beauty, justice, foundation, power, strength. This is what he is. Now there's many more. Right. These are the major ones. You understand? Mercy, compassion. You know, there's many more, but these are the major ones. In fact, we were given enough that we could deal with. Because we couldn't deal with him all at one time. Nobody could. Okay, so read.
And I will fill their treasures.
And Yahweh Elohim, will fill your treasures. You understand? When did that happen? On the day of Pentecost, after the death, burial, resurrection of Yahshua Messiah, the ascension, and the outpouring of the Holy Spirit on the Jew first, and then on us, the Gentile. That's when he filled our treasure. Is that about right? Mm-hmm. Read.
Yahweh possessed me in the beginning
now,
of his way.
Now Yahweh possessed me. Talking about Yahweh in the beginning of his way. Read.
Before his works of old.
Before his works of old. Before his works of old. Read.
I was set up from everlasting.
He was set up for everlasting.
From the beginning.
From the beginning.
Or ever the earth was.
For before all this came and anything, he came forth. Read.
When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no fountains abounding with water.
Read.
Before the mountains were settled, before the hills was I brought forth. While as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields.
Read.
Nor the highest part of the dust of the world. When he prepared the heavens, I was there. When he set a compass upon the face of the depth. When he established the clouds above. When he strengthened the fountains of the deep.
Read.
When he gave to the sea his decree that the waters should not pass his commandment. When he appointed the foundations of the earth, then I was by him.
Go ahead.
As one brought up with him. And I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him.
Okay, stop there. Give me real quick, John. John 1 and 1.
In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with Yahweh.
The Word was with Yahweh.
And the Word was Yahweh.
The Word was Yahweh.
The same was in the beginning with Yahweh.
The same was in the beginning with Yahweh.
All things were
Some
made by
Him. Some things were made by Him.
No. All things Wait. Were made by Him.
All things. Now listen, people. All things.
Yeah.
Could somebody come up with something that He didn't create before we go any further? You gonna bring the devil in there?
Oh, okay.
There's nothing that he did not create. Nothing. See, this is what's humbling me when I recognize that you are just as much a part of me as I am of you. You understand? Dr. Kelly said this. He said, one of our problems is recognizing the Holy Spirit in one another. He said, when you know you have the Holy Spirit, is when you love the brethren. Then the question comes up, who's your brother? Name me somebody that ain't. Regardless, you know, to smack a heavy, hard-headed, wicked, evil, adulterous, self-centered, egomaniac fool like me, it takes power. It took power. And on top of that, to get a needle out of my arm, that's the power that in Yahweh to transform or change a person. That's why I walk around here appearing that I'm heavy and high-minded. It's not that. All of my faith and honor and glory goes to Yahweh himself. Because I'm like Paul said, oh, what? Wretched man. That was me. And we got to come to that. And in Ezekiel the 36th chapter, what you don't have to get is going to tell you. Once you become conscious, you're going to loathe yourself for your old evil ways and for your things that were not good that you did. You're going to do that. That's what's in the book. So don't think when I get up here, I'm preaching a Emza. I'm not. I'm preaching the power of Yahweh. What he can do in your life if you let go and have some faith. Because he will build that faith. So strong that you can finally, when that man read back there, go back and read what you just read.
First among the requirements for securing spiritual blessings from these pages.
Now listen.
Is peace of mind.
How many walked into this path for peace of mind? How many got it now? You're only going to have it when you die and you're gone. I'm talking about The part of you that's always interfering in Yahweh showing you something. Or the influence of the satanic spirit in you. Because he will, that's his job. It's to influence you. Yahweh ain't the only name. You can call him Buddha. You can call him Shiva. You can call him Allah. He know who you're talking to. Yeah, but you don't. He do, but you don't. Read.
That's as when the master desires to pray, he chooses a place of solitude, apart from the press of daily living.
Now, when I left this class, people could automatically assume, he running, the same thing I left Pomona. They can't see Yahweh taking me to a place where I need to be alone so he can show me something. They got to think what they think in the carnal mind. I lived in an apartment for the first time in my life for 10 years. That's where he took me, according to what he just read about the solitude. That's where I needed to be, alone and by myself for years. And I finally had to accept that. Then he could show me something.
That's right.
But no, I got to have this, I got to have that, I got to have this. Okay, then you can show me. It don't work like that. Read.
Usually in the vast stillness of the mountainside,
this mountainside I'm talking about. Read.
Therein the majestic grandeur of the nature which he had helped his father to create in the realm of the invisible. The materialized Son of God stripped himself of all earthly restrictions and stood spiritually naked before the throne. Thus, out of the self of daily necessity, his mind became the instrument through which flowed the will of his father.
Can you dig that? Read.
Thus it is with the mind of the man today, alone with his communion, it is the will of the Father to reveal his children the mystery of his universe.
He said that to us. He's going to show us his will. Did you just hear what he read? Read.
Be still and know that I am God.
Be still and know that I am. Now you heard, if you pay attention to the moderator, which is the first lecture, you will do well. The founder said, if we understood the lecture, what could we do?
Go home.
Go home. So it's obvious we don't all understand it. So if you pay attention to the little things, he just said God. Remember, this is before the word Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua was preached. You understand? Dr. Kelly used the word God. Okay, read.
Once man has withdrawn from his physical surroundings,
read.
The next thing is the clearing of the mind.
Read.
For it is in a still small voice that God speaks.
That Yahweh Elohim speaks. Now the reason why I'm going through this is because these are basic.
Right.
You see, you're not coming down here just to get enthralled with all this knowledge we got down here. Remember, the first aim is to what? Help you find and know Yahweh as he really is and actually exists. That's the basic. But sometimes we leave that idea to get knowledge, to know about Nimrod and all these things. Now that's good because everything is an affirmatory to this teaching. In other words, Dr. Kennedy said himself, everybody go out. Go to the churches, go do this and go. He told us to go out and experience things. Yeah. Check things out, is that right? Mm-hmm. Why? Because they're only going to do is confirm this teaching is the right one. Mm-hmm. And that's what I found in my 30 whatever year journey. It all leads back to this class. I can't go nowhere. Yeah. But see, where my mistake was, I got so big-headed, I said it wrong. The church is wrong. You know, the Roman Catholics is wrong. I just walked around big-headed. We're the only one that got it. No, we're not. Just because you go to this class don't mean you saved. And because you don't go to this class don't mean you lost. That's the way it is. That's reality.
That's right.
Yahweh's looking upon the what? Give me 1 Samuel 16 chapter real quick and then go back for it. I only came up here to talk about the ends and dispensations. That's all I wanted to talk about. You know, Yahweh's too much. Yahweh's too much, man. Read.
1 Samuel 16 and 1.
Go down to about 5.
Fifth verse. And he said, peacefully.
Yeah, they asked him
peacefully.
They asked Samuel why he's coming. Read.
I am come to sacrifice unto Yahweh.
Read.
Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice.
Now, what it originally came for was to anoint the new king, because the first king, Saul, was kicked out. He was, what's the word? He was fired. You understand? Because he was disobedient to Yahweh when he told Saul what to do when he went and took over this particular city. Told him not to do something. He did it anyway. Yeah. Anyway, Yahweh, it said in the book, it says he gave him another spirit. That's what it says in the book. But what he's going down to Jesse's house for is to anoint the new king, which is David, one of the sons of Jesse. Read.
And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to the sacrifice. And it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab and said, surely Yahweh's anointed is before him.
Ain't that what we do? We look upon a person and make the judgment. We see, he is a handsome, striking man. Oh, she's a fine hammer. She looking good. Read.
Seventh verse. But Yahweh said unto Samuel,
what?
Look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused.
Now I refused him. The one you say, this got to be Yahweh's anointed, his elect. Read.
For Yahweh seeth not as a man.
Yahweh don't see like we see. How about that? Just like in Isaiah the 55th chapter, he says, my ways are not your ways, neither are your thoughts my thoughts. Read.
For man looketh on the outward appearance.
Now get that straight, people. We came in doing this, looking on the outward appearance. Is that right? That's how we came in this world. Yeah, we don't see like that. Now, what do you think? Looking at me like all crazy. But remember what happened up here when they disobeyed. And Yahweh say, you shall die instantaneously. Yeah, Adam lived 930 years, but he died instantaneously when he touched that tree. That right? He died in his consciousness. His consciousness was closed to the spirit and open to what? And guess what? We was in his loins. And when we came in there, it also says that death, how's that go down? Rain from Adam to Adam to Moses. Okay? So death was raining. We were in a dead state. You understand? You put the seed in the ground, it's in a dead state. You understand? Then it's watered or whatever, and all of a sudden it breaks through the earth, and it goes in from seed stage to bud stage, you know, into fruition. You understand? That's what we're doing. Because we are the seed of Abraham, which is Joshua. Read.
For man looketh on the outward appearance, man, but Yahweh looketh on the heart.
Now that's what Yahweh's looking on. He's not looking at how fine you think you are, how much money you think you got, what kind of car. He ain't looking on that. When you take off that flesh, you ain't gonna have none of that. No money, no car, no nothing. You know, so that's temporary. He's looking on what's inside these vessels that's everlasting. And that's the spirit. And then hopefully it's the spirit of Yahshua that's in all of us. Go back.
That's right.
Having done this, the meditation assumes a deeper significance.
When you clear your mind is clear, the meditation has a deeper significance.
Than merely study.
Now see there? Memory studying. So you can study, which is okay. But there's a deeper, significant part of you that's also dealt with while you're in your meditation of studying. Read.
It becomes a spiritual oneness with the Father.
And that's what you want. Everybody in here wants a spiritual oneness with the Father. This is called the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. But this is the body we want to be a part of. You understand what I'm saying? School to be a member of the school. I'm not saying that. I'm talking about being a member. This is the best. You understand? Okay, so read.
The revelation.
Hot in here. Go ahead.
The revelation, the divine pattern of the universe.
Everything in this school, believe it or not, people, and I can't stress this enough, because I didn't wait on him. Yahweh had to show me that if he doesn't reveal it to you, if he doesn't show you for himself, then you'll never get it. Thank you. Then you'll never get it. You never got it. And if you're impatient to wait on a revelation and think that you can read a book and instantly get it, it don't work like that. When the founder preached, he would tell them, just hear my words. Listen to my words. And the Holy Spirit in you will give you understanding. But you're not going to get it as soon as you get it. If I say Reggie, and he don't get it like that. It comes at a point of time, which is Ecclesiastes 3rd chapter, which you don't have to get. You know, there's a time for everything. Time for every season under heaven. Everything that happens has a time. And the time keeper is him.
That's right.
You understand? Remember, according to the ages and dispensations chart, it says this is eternity. Right here. The red or the cloud that surrounds this chart represents eternity. Time was placed in eternity. You understand? Limited from coming in the angelic, see, to the day of eternity, to the end. It says beginning, right here, beginning. Then it also says what? Ending. That ain't eternity. Eternity ain't gonna never end. He's talking about time. You understand? And time begin when? At the transgression. As soon as they transgressed, the sun started coming down. You understand? We.
The revelation, the divine pattern of the universe, embraces the existence of God, his divine law and eternal purpose. This theme is carried through the dispensations and ages.
Through the dispensations, which is what? A divine ordering of affair.
That's right.
From Yahweh to man. Something that has to happen right here, right here, right here, right here. It's a divine ordering of affairs. The word age is also world.
That's right.
So you have a world here and a world here. You understand? Mm-hmm. Now what's according to the scripture, a lot of people don't want to hear. Now this did not have a full end. This world did not have a full end. Mm-hmm. This world did not have a full end. Mm-hmm. But this one will. Mm-hmm. Now that can be proven. Now I hope to get to it. Read.
This theme is carried through the dispensations and ages as they are known to the religious students. Comparatively speaking, it is new, yet in reality it is old. Divine, physiological, spiritual, and scientific.
Read.
It is an interpretation of the Bible, revolutionary in its impact upon modern thinking. There is one concise pattern or plan followed.
There is one concise pattern or plan, right?
That's right.
Is this it? This it? This it? Transform into this, right?
Yeah.
So this is a definition of the word. How about that? Get that one? All right, read.
There is one concise pattern or plan followed by the Creator from the inception of the universe and has been revealed to the author by the divine source. First conceived in the realm of the invisible.
Read.
The objects of the pattern were then materialized in the visible realm. Counterparts of the original creation. God is invisible. It stands to reason that the products of his activity should likewise be invisible.
Read.
But having made man to be a visible physical pattern, it becomes necessary for the Father to crystallize.
See, so all of this is the crystallization of spirit. You understand? Spirit materialized. All the physical is spirit materialized. Read.
Right.
Read.
Make visible for man the objects of his creation.
See, he made it visible. Stop right there. Give me Psalms 19 division. This is what he made visible for us. Read.
Psalms 19. The heavens declare the glory of El.
The heavens declare the glory of El. Read.
And the firmament showeth his handiwork.
And the firmament shows his handiwork. Read.
Day unto day uttereth speech.
Day unto day uttereth speech. Read.
And night unto night showeth knowledge.
And night unto night. Now, do they say it's night time? Do you hear the sky say it's night time? Don't say that, huh? It's daytime. Don't do that. So what do you mean it uttereth speech? You understand what I'm saying? It's revealed to each and every. We was being revealed to even before we came to class. I mean, how could the Father of this creation justify sending you to the lake of fire and not show you a way out? But he said this is going to be the end of something, didn't he? Mm-hmm. So he wouldn't be justified. This is the, I don't like you, go to the lake. You know, he don't do it like that. He gives everybody an opportunity to know him as he really is and actually exists. That's why we got Romans 1, 19 and 20, where down there it says, and they are without what?
Excuse.
We ain't going to have no excuse. You understand? That's why I'm reading this scripture. Go on with that scripture.
Man is too limited to enter into the invisible realm with God and behold the creation in its purity.
He's too limited. Well, then how did Dr. Kelly have a divine vision and revelation? If a man is too limited. See, he just separated him. See that body laying down? He laid that body down and separated him and brought his consciousness up. In other words, released him from the shackles of carnality.
Very well said.
Okay?
Very good.
For a moment, he said, dig this, in a moment. You know what we're dealing with here when we talk about Yahweh? This ain't just I'm going down to class. This soul salvation is at stake right while you sit in these seats. I'm scared sometimes when I come to class for some odd reason. You know, because sometimes I feel, do I really got it, Father? And I stop comparing myself with other people and I compare them with what he's given me. Okay. Now I'm okay. I'm a lot more okay. Read.
This is a future state which man shall have to attain if he never achieves his theologically inspired ambition of being with God and his angels.
That's right. Read. With Yahweh, Elohim, and his angels. Read.
From the magnificence of his solar system and the majesty of the mighty seas, to the molecular structure of a grain of sand.
Listen, what kind of person talks like that? To the molecular structure of a grain of sand. Mr. Polytechnical himself, Yahweh Elohim, read.
The challengelessness of the spirit law points.
Changelessness,
thank you. The changelessness of the spirit law points to a fixed.
What do you mean,
pattern?
Changelessness? See? We're taught, if you get over there in Philippians 2 and 5 real quick, let me show you what I'm talking about, while we're talking about, and then whole Malachi 3 and 6.
Philippians 2 and 5.
Philippians 2 and 5, read it as
let
it is.
Let this mind.
Now see, in the scripture, Dr. Killian, correct this.
Right.
It's read, let this mind, read.
Be in you, which was also in Yahshua the Messiah.
Which was also in Yahshua the Messiah. Now, you know what? We have a carnal mind. And our mind is subject to what?
Change.
That's not what Yahweh was talking about. That's what Dr. Kelly had to change it to spirit. Let this spirit, talking about the same one that was in Yahshua the Messiah,
that's right.
Be in you. Why? Malachi 3 and 6.
Malachi 3 and 6. For I am Yahweh.
I am Yahweh.
I change
not. I change not.
Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. Even from the days of your fathers, you are gone away from mine ordinances.
Okay. Yahweh said, I change not. That's why we talk about immutability. Okay? He changed not. But our minds are subject to change. He might have 2,500 times while we're sitting in these seats. But he don't change. That's where we had the problem. Now, what I'm saying is, while I'm talking about a still, quiet voice and peace of mind, is because the devil comes to rob you of that. His job is to divide and conquer.
That's right.
And that's what he does with us. He got us, you know, I love these cats. I love them. I love everybody in this class. But what his job is, to get me not to like him. To get me tripping on Dr. so-and-so in another school. Tripping on this and that and this and that. And that keeps you from seeing the oneness and stillness of Yahweh. Because you, how you gonna say, if I'm doing this, how am I gonna hear something quiet? I'm taking too much racket in me. That's me. All right. Read.
From Malachi? Even from the days of your fathers.
No, that's enough Malachi. Go back.
Man being made in the image and likeness of God.
Now see, he's the same thing I said earlier. Man is made in the image and likeness of Yahweh. You understand? He ain't said nothing about ego. He ain't said nothing about concepts, theories, and opinions. He's talking about the part of us that's made in his likeness and his image. Remember, he told Jeremiah, I knew thee before I placed thee in the womb. So that means that there was a life before we were placed in these bodies. You understand what I'm saying? And this is a round trip. And that's what our, how we used to say it,
Our destination
is our origin.
Yeah.
Okay? Read.
Man being made in the image and likeness of God follows the same plan in his progress as does a star in the vault of heaven.
Now listen, it's beautiful. Read.
So to man was this plan revealed, now that he is a creature permitted to reason. God first shows to Moses, then to the Apostle John, and the last time to the author.
Read.
Through the angels of the invisible realm
now
and
remember,
the patriarchs.
Remember, when you look at this tabernacle pattern, the angels are up here in the invisible realm. Is that about right? So how are we to know that they're angels? You understand? They ought to come behind this veil and down into here. You see this angel? He came through the veil, and he's dealing here with the high priest. And you can go back and pick up John the Baptist's daddy on that and see if he saw somebody when you read it. Read.
Though the angels of the invisible realm and the patriarchs and the prophets of the visible world spoke and wrote under the influence of the Holy Spirit.
You can find that in 2 Peter 1:19 and 20. You don't have to get it. Go ahead.
Truth in its simplicity was not revealed to them.
What he's talking about is when you go around here from Abraham and you listen to what he said, patriarchs and Noah and all of them boys, and then you got Isaiah and the rest of them. Okay? Now he's talking about the understanding of all that was not revealed to them. You understand? When they went and prophesied, the prophets, they would go out and say, thus saith Yahweh. And then when they finished saying what they had to say, they returned to being just a normal man.
Yeah.
You understand? And you can prove that with Elijah when he goes and kills the 450 priests of Baal with Jezebel and her husband had. And he kills the 450 priests of El and proves the power of Yahweh with the water and all that.
Right. That's right.
Okay? And he proves it. It's beautiful. I'm trying to slow down. But after all of that happens, he goes and hides in a cave. You understand what I'm saying? So the Holy Spirit was not ever present within them then until the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Okay.
Now he's with us forevermore.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because he had to fulfill all of this. All of this was fulfilled. He just read it in the thing, if you paid attention. Joe's son, he said, out of Israel what?
I have my son.
Out of Egypt have I called my son, right?
Correct.
He also fulfilled Moses when he said, the man that remembers after your life are dead. It's all in that scripture. And that's why we don't teach the Matthew through Revelation. We teach the whole book. Because if you just jump in the book of Matthew through Revelation, you're not going to know what's going on. Well, why is he doing this? And why? You're not going to know nothing he's doing when he's walking the earth, the man you call Jesus. Because it doesn't make any sense until it's connected to the law and the prophets, which are the first five books and the next 34 books, from Genesis to Malachi. Is that about right? You got to do that. I'm not mad. Okay. I'm just happy. You know, in loudmouth, if you read, please.
It was the prerogative of God alone to reveal the deepest of his secrets to whosoever he will.
Listen, to whosoever he will. He may not come and give them to you. He may not give them to me. But he's going to give them to whosoever he wills. Read.
It is significant that both John and Paul refer to Jesus Christ as God manifest in the flesh.
Okay, Emmanuel. That's what that means. Right, Reg? Mm-hmm. Okay, he's talking about Moses and John. Read.
Thus he, Christ, while in the invisible...
Now we know that Christ is a title. It is not a name.
That's right.
Okay? That's why I'm having him read this. So that when you hear it... See, I used to have a hard time. That's why everybody runs to the Holy Name Bible. You know, not realizing some mistakes in there too. But it's so easier to read than the King James. You know, because you got to flip all them to Lord God, Jesus Christ and all that. It got crazy. You know, but after a while, as you go up and level your level, it gets easier. It gets easier. It gets easier. Christ is a title, just like Lord and God. What does Christ mean?
Anointed one.
How about that? His name was Jesus Anointing. You understand? This is a name, the only name up here that is true, but it's erroneous. And the thing about it is, people, Dr. Kennedy was right about you have to be like a child. Because all you got to do is pick up a good dictionary or encyclopedia, especially if you go back and get an old one. And you'll say, tell you that the letter J is the newest letter added to the English alphabet. It should be behind the Z, but they stuck it between the I and the K. Okay? And that's just Jesus. And all it is a hook and get you. That's a hook. You understand what I'm saying? But then I go talk to my mom. I had somebody pull a gun on me. Take away my Jesus, fool. That's how serious some people are with Jesus. Count yourself blessed. You are blessed to be here. And don't think that it's not going to be rough. Because the Messiah said, we shall suffer for his name's sake. And you're going to have to. We look just like he did when he walked around. Say the things he was saying. Here we come with the truth and what. How many people? This class is not, I'm not, don't mean this out of shading or being mean. We're at the end. This class is not going to get full, gigantic full. In reality, it's full already. Because we are encompassed by, how did that go?
So great a cloud of
witnesses. They're all here. Where else you going to go when you take off the flesh? To heaven? No, you can be in a heavenly state right while you're in this physical body. Remember when they was out here in the wilderness, one and a half tribes got an inheritance. That's on the natural. This, on this side of the Jordan, represents the flesh, right? And this is taking off the flesh, right? But they got an inheritance on this side. So our inheritance is the Holy Spirit on this side. You understand? That's what we have already received. We're not waiting for it to come. And it says in the book also that it's if it were possible to deceive the very elect, right?
Right.
But it ain't possible. Read.
Christ, while in this invisible, was the source from which these mysterious and secret originated.
Read.
Both the visible and invisible.
Now remember, this is Yahweh Elohim manifesting in a physical body. So all these miracles are going to explain that all these miracles that he did was already authored way back here. Read.
It is for this reason that while he was in the flesh, he knew all things.
Remember who he is manifested in the flesh. He knew all things, read.
And was able to perform all miracles. He raised the dead. Healed the sick. Gave sight to the blind. And read the unexpressed thoughts of men.
Read.
He caused the fig tree to wither. And die, and with a word.
Stilled the ocean. Did he not? He did. Read.
These things were possible in the visible.
Listen to what he's reading, because it's very important. These things were possible where?
In the visible counterparts of the universe.
Read.
Because they were first established in the invisible.
Read.
Christ was able to perform these seeming miracles.
Now see, we walk around here talking about miracles, mega miracles. Dr. Kennedy said these seemingly miracles. They're not miracles. That's what we call them, read.
In the visible universe, because he was part of their inception. When he was with them in the invisible.
Is this phenomenal? When he was with them in the invisible. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All of the things that he did when he walked this earth was already established.
Okay.
He knew how to walk. He established it in the invisible. And guess what? He established us in the invisible. Mm-hmm. He knows the heart and mind of man. He knows what we're going to do and what we're not going to do. He knows our limits and bounds. This makes it limits and bounds and limited because we're in a physical body. Read.
Before the creation of even the solar system, of which this earth is part thereof, man knows them to be the divine origin because they are demonstrated by the divine pattern of the universe, which was shown first to Moses and then to the author. That pattern, as it has been revealed in this materialization in the tangible of the original divine law in the intangible.
That's enough, man. I can't take it. That's enough. Here's your ages and dispensation chart. And I'm going to say this before I get down. On each one of these ages, there's a scripture. Read 1 Corinthians 10 and 11. I learned this from a brother that I love very much when I was in Oakland in 1980s. He didn't teach me. It was the Holy Spirit that taught me, but that was the vessel. You understand? Just like Joe, he ain't teaching me nothing, but what comes out of his mouth, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We don't want you to think we're following after a man. It's not about an actual natural man. Because the Holy Spirit is the only teacher we have in John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, he shall teach you, not me. We'll know there's been given much. But it ain't will. It's what's in that vessel. And he's got a purpose, just like Joe. You know, I was thinking about that coming over. We all got a purpose. Just do it. What you're going to do anyway. Well, when you do it, other people can learn from it. Believe it or not, people learn about a lot of stuff from you. I was going to get into some things, but I'm not. Read the scripture.
1 Corinthians 10 and 11. Now all these things happen unto them as a warning to others.
Now look at all these things that happen in these two dispensations happen to us. It's a warning. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what it said?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's put the end of the post-diluvian age and let's read this scripture. 1 Corinthians 10 and 11.
Now all these things happen unto them as a warning to others.
Now all these things that happen in this post-diluvian age happen as an example, as a warning to us. You understand what I'm saying? Not to look back and judge, oh, if I was in that garden, I wouldn't have did that. If I was the children of Israel, I wouldn't have did that. You know, yes, you would have. Because you're doing it now. Okay, so it's a warning here, and it's a warning there. Now let's look on this chart, where we're currently up against the wall at, and see what it says. Give me 2 Thessalonians, 1st chapter, please.
2 Thessalonians 1:6-8. Six. Seeing it is a righteous thing with Elohim.
Is that verse 1?
You said 6.
No, let one, give it 1 first.
Okay.
Read 1.
2 Thessalonians 1. Paul and Silvanus and Timotheus unto the church of the Thessalonians in Elohim our Father and Yahshua the Messiah our Savior, grace unto you and peace from Yahweh our Father.
Now read 6-8.
6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with Yahweh to recompense tribulations to them that trouble you, and to you who are troubled, rest with
now
us.
Now you that are troubled, rest with us. Read.
When Yahshua the Messiah shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
When Yahshua the Messiah and his mighty angels shall be revealed from heaven, doing what?
In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not Yahweh.
See, no excuse. Our first aim is to what? Help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and actually exists. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Now, this is the, this, I'm going to give one more scripture. Isaiah 28:9-10. Now, I want to read these because these scriptures, the founder would use, how many people have seen the founder use that scripture for Isaiah 28:9-10? He uses it almost every time he got on the floor. And I kept saying, why do you use this scripture so much? Because it's the key. I thought the rest was something else. Talking about the rest? But this is the rest. Read.
Isaiah 28:9-10. Whom shall he teach knowledge?
Now whom shall who teach? Yahweh Elohim. Whom shall he teach knowledge? Read.
And whom shall he make to understand
doctrine?
Now
who is he going to make to understand doctrine? Read.
Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast.
Now stop right there. What is the milk?
Simple doctrine.
The milk is the law and the prophets. That's the milk. In other words, when a woman's pregnant, she gets her child, she puts the child on one breast, right? And moves it to the left, to the other breast, right? A little here and a little there, right?
Right.
And when she finishes weaning the child, she cuts her breast off.
No.
No, because we still need the law and the prophets. You understand? We still need them. You understand? I know that's kind of blunt, but I'm just, okay, read.
For precept must
now
be
listen,
upon...
precept. This gate is a precept. Read.
Upon precept. Precept upon precept. Line upon line. Line upon line. Here a little. And there a little.
Blood. Line, right? Mm-hmm. Water. Line, right? Mm-hmm. Spirit. Line, right? 40 line, right? That's your precept upon precept, your precept upon precept. That's your line upon line, your line upon line. Read.
For with stammering lips and another tongue will he speak to his people.
Read. That's at the fulfillment. Read.
To whom he said, this is the rest.
Now this is the rest. This blood, I know, when it came to me, I said, wow. When it comes to you, it's impossible to please Yahweh if you don't pay attention and do what he says. You must have blood, water, spirit, 40. You must have death, burial, resurrection. Why? Galatians 4:24.
Galatians 4:24.
Read.
Which things are an allegory? I'll start with 23. But he who was of the bondwoman was born after the flesh.
No, where is
24?
3:24.
Oh, 3:24.
Thank you, John.
Wherefore, the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto the Messiah.
See, and that's what we do when we go through the death, burial, and resurrection of Yahshua Messiah. We bring you where?
That we might be justified by faith.
We bring you to the Messiah. That's what the law and the prophets does. Is that right? Is it right?
Yeah.
It's important. Now, in some schools, And I'm going to mention this because I'm talking about it in some school because I've been in them. They don't believe in that. They don't preach blood, water, spirit party. They don't do that or be obedient. So what they're doing is, you done canceled Yahshua Messiah. You see these 4 points on this altar? You see the 4 points of blood that has to be on this altar sin sacrifice?
Yeah.
What does all that point to?
Death.
Death, and it also pointed to him, is that right? Did he have to have 4 points of blood on him? But if you don't want to go through the basics, you're eliminating him.
Yes.
The water, let's go to the water even. Now when he came to John, he did what? He got baptized what? In the Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost? Or in the water? See, he got baptized in the water. But he didn't do it as an everlasting covenant. He did it to fulfill all of these washings.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? But when you don't want to go precept upon precept, precept upon precept, you eliminate, what you basically do is eliminate the whole court right about. Do anybody understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You eliminate it. So you're eliminating the Messiah. You're saying he didn't come to fulfill. Just like people nowadays tell you that there's still sin everywhere. Then John the Baptist lied. When he said, behold the Lamb of Yahweh to do what? What is he talking about? The only sin in this age is blasphemy. That's what he said, the Messiah. He said in his time or in the age to come, the only sin will be blasphemy. Is that about right? You understand? I know I said a whole bunch. But people, you know, it's like when you get something from this teaching, you want to share. He gets more excited than I do. So I feel good because he wants you to know. We want you to know so bad we wish we could just take it and just boom, clear it on you. You understand? Because when we got it, that's how it hit us. You want to share it with everybody. You want everybody to know it, good or bad. It doesn't matter. You want them to know that you're in the right place and this teaching is the greatest thing that has ever been given mankind. Ever been given mankind. Everything you knew or thought or your conceptualization, your theories, and they're wrong. They were wrong before you came to this school. I didn't say that. That's what the founder said. If you thought it, it was wrong. Simple for the fact you think you thought it. You understand? So I'm going to get on and I'm thankful to be here and everybody, don't worry about who don't come. You come. You understand? Then learn everything you can before it's eternally too late. Listen. Pay attention. And look it. Don't be scared to walk up to Reggie and say, Reggie, I don't understand what you say because you explain it. If Reggie has the understanding, Reggie going to break it down for you and give you a book or some proof. And the soul is going to go with the dean and everybody else in here. But we don't want you to feel that because you don't talk like somebody else. Anybody want to talk like me is a dang fool anyway. Because I'm street. That's why he brought me in here. I'm street.
Yeah.
And if I could say what I would say in the street, I wouldn't be in here. I'd be a Pomona. No, just kidding. Just kidding.
That's true.
No, at one time. I don't know how they do now, but at one time I did. They didn't say nothing. You know, but everybody's got a gift in there. And I want to hear the gift come out of all of you guys' mouth. And that gift is the Holy Spirit. That's the only gift. No other gift. And my wish and my desire and my hope is peace of mind for everybody. You know? Ask God to remove the flesh from your inside so that you won't be concentrating on that. Everything's going well. I don't care how bad a situation looks in your life, whether it's with your family, your children, or Yahweh going to fix it. I got 8 children. Don't none of them go to class no more. That don't bother me. They already responsible for what they heard. You understand? For the years that they were here. You understand? So just remember that you got the greatest king ever. His name is Yahshua. And he lives inside you. And he's there. And he's right now, he's cleansing that tabernacle. He's getting rid of all of your concepts and opinion. Remember, we want to know him in the power of his resurrection. Mm-hmm. Right?
Right.
But we can't know him as long as we think we're running the show. You understand? And he's got to show you how you think you're running the show. Everything that you need is already there. Be patient. You know what I mean? Patience means to endure without complaining. As long as you're complaining, you're in trouble. There's nothing to complain about. Now take it from somebody that did all this stuff I'm talking to you about. You don't have to go after my way, because it's not. Hims has been a wretched blip-blop fool for a long time. And I don't mind, because you got to be brought low so that he can raise you high. But you don't want to admit you mess up, and you so doggone perfect, you're going to stay down. Stay up there thinking you can invincible, like I did. He got a hammer for every one of our heads. So learn everything you can before it's eternally too late. Hallelujah.
Our next speaker this afternoon will be the Dean, Dr. Joe Williams. You can go 10, 15 minutes over if you need to.
Good afternoon. There was a lot said, but I'm going to try to be brief, but to the point. Philippians 2 and 5, and let me have 2 Corinthians 2, 10 and 4. I think that's what I want.
Philippians 2 and 5.
Now hold it right there before you move on. Now, the first speaker talked about the mechanics of the teaching, which is fantastic, because these types of shafts is to lead you up to the Messiah.
Right.
You see, this plate here is not on your 40-plate chart. This is called, we call it, Dr. Kinney named it the spiritual temple plate. And what it points to is Yahshua the Messiah himself. You see? And it shows how he presents himself as a living sacrifice.
Right.
In other words, we haven't written on the cross, but it's symbolic. He's walking around alive, but he is a prepared sacrifice.
Yeah.
Okay? They're showing him get baptized by John. They're showing how the Spirit descended on Yahshua by saying, "This is my beloved Son and whom I am well pleased." You see? In the holy place, he's showing how that he says, "I am the light, I am the bread," and he is also the intercessor, or he prays the Father for you. Okay? And also, they beat him after his crucifixion, because he did die, and he took off the flesh. And you see him here, you see, in the realm of eternity, you see, being advocate for us that we might know. Now, the previous speaker said, showed how that he said, "Let this spirit be in you which was in Yahshua the Messiah." Now let me say this, and please, don't miss this. The purpose and plan of Yahweh is complete. If that was not so, we could not sit up here and talk about it.
That's right.
It was just that simple. The purpose and plan of Yahweh is complete. This is meat, you see. So we can talk about the types of shadows all we want. That's milk. And we need to talk about the types of shadows and the milk for this reason. There are some folks who come in here from the church. They're going to ask you about water baptism.
That's right.
They're going to ask you about the Passover Supper. They're going to ask you about what went on in my church, the Seventh-day Adventist, or the Catholic, or the Baptist, or
Presbyterian.
Yes. They're going to ask you about that. You should be able to explain that to them and draw that out by the scriptures. You see, and when you can't do that, it ain't enough. You see? Now let this spirit be in you which was in Yahshua Messiah. Now, we'll talk. talks about this all the time, and that is the science. I ain't got time to draw this out like I want, but I'm going to definitely hit it. Science of mind. Versus the law of the spirit. Now, let me say it like this, real simple and plain cornbread terminology. The egotistical, misdirected personality versus the Holy Spirit. Let that mind be in you which was in Yahshua the Messiah. Now, so if you don't get it, if you don't understand when we say the law of the Spirit, understand the egotistical misdirected personality, which we all have, versus the Holy Spirit, which we're trying to come to.
Yeah.
You see? Now, the question is, what are you talking about? Let this Spirit be in you, which was in Yahshua the Messiah. First, we got to identify what the egotistical misdirected personality is, in plain cornbread terminology, in the flesh. Now, I had a talk last night with my kids about this. You know how your kids are. They want everything. They want not one or two cookies. I mean, it's five kids. You've only got a bag of cookies, but, you know, their appetite is for five. But they can't go, they're going to take two because there's some more. You ain't that many in the box, in the bag. You know what I mean? They want the cookies, but she want five, this one want five, can't give them all five. But this is what they want. And some milk, can't have milk tonight, we only got 1 gallon. We gotta have that for breakfast in the morning. You get my point? But your flesh says, I want some cookies and milk. That's what your ego says. See, the ego thrives on pleasure, what I want, what I feel satisfied me. And what the ego says is this. If I have to cry to get what I want, I'm going to cry. If I got to get what I want, if I got to get what I want, I'm going to do it. If I got to lie to get what I want, I'm going to do it. You guys get my point?
Yeah.
This is what we do because we don't understand who we are. We think that we are Joe Williams, whoever we say we are. You see, if I have to kill to get what I want, I'll do that. Example, O.J. Simpson. His wife left him and divorced him and moved on. But you know, he didn't want to know what the hell she doing. Maybe she went. You get my point?
Yeah.
It's over. But you know what? His flesh. Maybe I should just put that here. Like this here. His flesh will not let go. Because his desires, what he wants, how he feels, what he thinks. You see? Because the Holy Spirit will release you from the flesh.
Mm.
Everybody with me so far? Let this Spirit be in you which was in Yahshua the Messiah. I'm just trying to identify what this is first. Now we use the chart as a tool to show you a spiritual principle or a spiritual reality. I'll just take this one right now. Now this is talking about Moses, the track of the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. How they was in darkness, they was in ignorance, they was in bondage. You see, they were oppressed, they were suppressed, they were depressed. Whatever it was, that's the state condition of these people down here in the land of Egypt. You see, psychologically and spiritually so, they were dead.
That's right.
Now, we're going to look at Moses to see, we got to bring that up you see, into the present kingdom age. You with me? We back here in post-Diluvian, way back here with Moses. Now we fast forward over here in the present kingdom age where we sit right now. You see, how is this going to do us any good to talk about Moses? Well, we got to see what the heck went on down there. They were in bondage. They were depressed. Now, I don't know about y'all. I got a whole lot of problems. Not one, not two, not three. I said I have a whole lot of problems. Don't get me wrong. I'm not going to impose them on you.
Legion.
You know what I'm saying? And my point is, I got... You see, however, one thing I do know, so do you. You see, and as a result of the problems you have, that's the flesh, and that's what clutters your mind, that keep your eyes on everything but Yahweh.
That's right.
You see, now, we take these charts. I use Moses to show you these people were stuck on building what? Treasure cities. You see, that's what their job was. That's what they had to do. Build treasure cities. They were subject to Pharaoh. I can get book on that. And maybe I should. Just to make a point. Genesis 15 and 12. I think that's where it is. Now I'm only getting that one script just to make a point. Now again, they're in bondage. So we use this chart to show the state condition of the Israelites on these people, because it says, out of Egypt I called my son. Now, hold it right there. Let me know when you get that. We use this chart right here, the map chart. Simply because it says, proving the existence and destruction of Satan and his angels through the dispensations and ages. And I'm letting you know, every day you come face to face with a satanic spirit.
That's right.
That's why you lie. Okay? That's why you cloak and hide certain things.
That's right.
That's why you don't expose certain things, because you come in contact with this boy here. Now, we got this man here. This is the amalgamation of a conglomeration of an accord mass. Talking about this man just like the earth. You are an earthen vessel. You with me so far? Everybody got a volume. Mm-hmm. You see? But listen, what we're trying to get you to see, there is life after death. Right now, you are psychologically and spiritually dead, because of the experiences that you had in life. In other words, after Cain kind of came out of the garden, you see, he built the city of Enoch. You see, without divine specification.
That's right.
Yep. Nimrod built the Tower of Babel without divine specifications. In other words, it was not spiritually inspired.
That's right.
It was not from Yahweh. Moses lived a life with the Egyptians, you see, to get him ready for the mission that Yahweh already preordained and foreknew what Moses was going to do when he got down here. So we use this chart to show you how this man, this king, he is a composite of Cain, Nimrod, Nebuchadnezzar, the Medes and the Persians, Alexander the Great, Pagan Rome, and Papal Rome. That is what this man represents. You see, from the beginning all the way to it's just death.
That's right.
It's just the world. It's just the flesh. You see, it's simple. Gambling, drugs, pimping. I can go on. Well, yeah, some folks pimp on a regular basis. Some folks think that pimping ain't got to be about being pimping.
That's woman. Right. That's right.
You can pimp the one you with and call yourself lover.
Yep.
And I can tell you this. You always giving and they always taking.
Yep.
And at no point are they ever giving but what you can do for me. Mm-hmm. I bet you understood that.
Okay.
You see, my point is, it's the flesh, folks. It's just death. Now, let me say this. When you give, you should give without expectation. Am I right?
Absolutely.
If I give you a gift, I ain't looking for nothing back.
But people do.
When you cannot give, then that means you got a problem. And what I mean by that is this. When you're always expecting and never giving, I'm telling you right that. There you are right there. And this is the reason for that. Yahweh so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, which was Yahshua Messiah. Not only that, he already prepared the sacrifice way back there and around eternity. Talking about Yahweh Elohim. And then it was Yahweh himself who got into that body and walked around in his own creation for you. So that you can see and understand who he is. You see? In other words, what I'm trying to get you to see, that Yahweh is spirit. You see? He is made up of intelligence, wisdom, knowledge, beauty, love, justice, foundation, power, and strength. That is what he is. Likewise, that is also your divine makeup.
Yeah.
The same attributes that he has, you have, but they're hidden. And they're hidden in the flesh. Everybody with me so far?
Yeah.
So therefore, when I say flesh, everybody say, oh, it's the body. This is the grave, folks. You see? But the carnality, that's the flesh. And that's what's clothed in the body. You see, because there's a veil up, that's your second part of the veil. It is a veil that prevents you from seeing the reality of who you really are. You know what I mean? I'll say it like this. Did you get my scripture?
Yes.
Call the first one before I run out of time.
The first one was
Philippians.
Yeah, read that real quick.
Philippians 2 and 5.
Come on, read please.
Let the Spirit be in you, which was also in Yahshua the Messiah, who being in the form of Elohim, thought it not robbery to be equal with Yahweh.
That's good enough right there. Let the Spirit be in you, which was in Yahshua the Messiah. Why did I call that? Because see, Yahshua, I'll say it like this, got on the cross and died. And when he died, he gave his spirit, all of it, to mankind. In order that you might know who he is. Once you understand who he is, then you'll find out who you are. Because you find out that your destination is your origin. You're trying to get to heaven because you come back because you came from heaven. And when you what we're trying to do is to get you into the realm of eternity by getting you to understand and identify who and what the flesh is. But if you don't know what the flesh is, you get deceived. What I mean by that is this. Girl, you know I love you. I do anything for you. But ain't nothing happening. I just keep hearing it. After a while, you say, it's lip service.
That's right.
Yeah. That way, after a while, you've been saying it for 2-3 years. It's just... It's just lip service. And y'all know me. You can tell me you love me all you want, but I know you love me by how you act. Because you vote by your actions and your manifestations. Isn't that right? You see, it's how that's what y'all should see. Yahweh said we're going to do in the law of the prophets. And then he came along and fulfilled it. You get the point? So let that spirit be in you, which was in Yahshua Messiah. That's enough. Because I'm pushed for time. That's why I drew that out. I called another scripture, right?
2 Corinthians 10 and 4.
Now read that.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
He says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. It's not like they did down there in San Bernardino. Thinking they did something. All they did was raise a little hell. Scared everybody. Enough for me to say, we need to read the firearm policy. We need to read the firearm policy to find out what the deal is, and if we even have to address the firearm policy. You see, somebody, like I said, if somebody walk in the door and start shooting, everybody inside, come on, y'all going first. I hope next week everybody ain't over there.
I'll give
you. That's why I
you get my point? Because who that?
right.
You see, but on the same token, you want to be prepared. At least discuss it, that we have a plan. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. Nevertheless, I'm talking about the flesh. Now see how Yahweh took me out of the spirit, put me into the flesh, talking about them folks. But I use it as a spiritual principle of the type to show me a type of the shadow show forth a spiritual principle about what's going on, the state and condition of that man. Read, please.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Now, carnal just simply means the flesh. Read on.
But mighty through Elohim to the pulling down of strongholds of rebels.
Read on.
Casting down imagination.
Casting down imaginations. What you think, what you feel, what you imagine. Like I had a conversation with a lady on Friday. So she's real religious at work. She got a really nice Bible, too. I said, listen. Do you know Jesus? You believe Jesus' birthday was on the 25th of December? Oh, sure. I said, really? I said, why don't you bring your Bible in for tomorrow and I'll prove to you by the scriptures it was not on the December 25th. She said, well, nobody really knows the date. I said, you don't know the date. I said, but I'm sure Yahweh knows the date. Otherwise, what did he give you the book for? I said, the book is a mystery, right? So, the first day I couldn't get around to it because I was busy. Then finally, Yahweh blessed the clinic and was nobody in there for a whole hour. I said, did you bring your book? I brought my book. Really nice book, too. We went in there and I showed her how the birthday was June 6th, 9 o'clock in the morning, by the scriptures. You see, now, this is my point. I said, you disagree with anything? She said, I'll look into it. I said, but do you disagree with anything? I'll look into it. I said, what you going to look into? Because we just looked in the book. So what you going to look at? You going to go ask somebody?
The pastor.
Either way, I'm comfortable. The point at the end of the day, she wasn't teaching me. That's the problem. Her flesh had a problem.
Yeah, with that.
It was the truth. No matter how you looked at it.
Yeah.
You see, now, Christmas is Christmas is Christmas. It's a pagan holiday. There's nothing wrong with giving.
Very true.
And there's nothing wrong with eating on the day of Christmas. Because I'm going to tell you right now, you got to eat. So there's nothing wrong. You eat every day. If it wasn't, you would eat anyway. There's nothing wrong with that either. Same thing with it. But when you start thinking that that is Jesus' birthday and start celebrating it all, then that's carnal.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's why we tell you how it is. Can't you buy your family a present or a gift? We don't care about that. But don't get mad at me if you don't get something either. Especially when you didn't give nothing. So, that's the flesh. You see? Now, I ain't gonna hold y'all over too long. Just for a few more minutes. I just want to identify science of mind, which is the egotistical, misdirected personality, you with me? Versus the law of the spirit. It is the Holy Spirit that's gonna teach you everything.
That's right.
Let this mind be in you, which was in Yahshua Messiah. Okay? Now when Yahshua got on that cross, I caught one more scripture. I know I did. Did I finish that up? About the casting down imaginations?
Casting down imaginations is every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of Yahweh.
Read on.
And bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of the Messiah.
That's good enough right there. Alright?
Genesis 15 and 12.
Now, that I brought this up for this reason why we use this chart. And how that Israel was in bondage. And that it was Yahweh, or God, that put them down in this situation. Read on.
When the sun was going down,
read.
A deep sleep fell upon Abram.
Read on.
And lo, a horror of great darkness fell upon him.
Mm-hmm.
And he said unto Abram, know of a surety,
read.
That thy seed shall be a stranger in a land, and in not theirs, and shall serve them.
Now he said, now look, Abraham. Your seed that's in your loin, when I give you this kid, your seed is going to go down to a land and know not of. And listen, it's going to be evilly treated. And the land that they're going to go to is not there because this is the land I'm going to give you. But this is where they're going to go. In other words, they got to fall.
Yeah.
You got to see yourself in a fallen state, a humbling state, where at least we can talk to you. But when you arrogant, egotistical, think you, I ain't saying like one, just think you know every damn thing, can't nobody tell you nothing? This is you right here. We gotta wait till you fall first. Once you fall, just maybe we can tell you something.
I don't throw the rock.
You see? And what I'm trying to get you to see is this. Once the adversary is exposed, and when I say the adversary exposed, when the lie is exposed, meaning that his true name is Yahshua, the true name is Yahweh. You see, it was Yahshua resurrecting a quickening spirit, not a physical body.
That's right.
You see, Yahshua didn't come into institute or to start or begin anything. He came in to fulfill that was written in the law and the prophets. You with me so far? That's the lie that's been exposed. Maybe we can fit. And that Jesus' birthday is not December 25th. You follow what I'm saying? Versus June 6th. You see, sorry, no, you get my point? You see, and I'm going to sit down in just a second. Read on, I'm going to make one more point.
And shall serve them,
read.
And they shall afflict them,
you know,
400
Israel
years.
Israel is going to be going to serve Pharaoh or the adversary. Read on.
And also that nation whom they shall serve,
read.
Will I judge.
Read on.
And afterwards shall they come out,
read.
With great substance.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt go to
That's
thy...
That's enough right there. Now, I said that, and I'm going to sit down. Dr. Kinney told us that Yahweh is the generator. And it was taught today that Yahweh hid himself, Yahweh hid himself from himself, revealed himself to himself, and that your destination is your origin. Yeah. But it was Yahweh who come down and took a residence in Adam,
mm-hmm.
and walked around in his own creation. What I'm saying to you, if your destination is your origin and you begin in heaven because you have these attributes, as you come down in a physical body, talking about you, it is also Yahweh or spirit law that takes up residence in this physical body and sits on your throne. Mm-hmm. And the first organ that is made in your body is the nervous system.
That's right.
And from the nervous system comes the circulatory system, and all the rest of the body is formed. And after the body is formed, just as the creation is coming in by the pattern. You with me so far? Mm-hmm. It is Yahweh Elohim himself who takes up residence in that body. Or it is spirit law taking up residence in that body, just as he's also taking up residence in his body. Or he quickens the body and all life begins on earth. So as Israel is making an exodus out of the land of Egypt, you see, you are making an exodus out of your mother's womb. And as you're coming out of your mother's womb, you're going to have a beginning on earth. You with me so far? And just as Israel's coming up out of the land of Egypt, they're going to have a beginning in the wilderness of Sinai to go on and receive their inheritance. And at some time, you're going to grow up to be a big man or a big woman. And guess what? Somebody's going to expose you to your bad attitude, your evil ways. You see? Your stubbornness, you see, I can go on, but you got to get the point.
Yeah.
Nobody's exempt from it. Yeah. You see, everybody has this egotistical, misdirected personality. But once you see it and identify, you say, is that me? Like that kid said, didn't I do that? Yeah, that's you.
Yeah.
You see, but it was the Holy Spirit that revealed to you who that egotistical, misdirected personality is. And the founder said it like this. And I'm going to come down. He said, Yahweh, when I had that vision and revelation, Yahweh could do nothing with me until first. He had to get rid of that, get past that egotistical, misdirected personality. The part of me that was not him.
That's right.
But he had to deal with the part of him that was him, which are these attributes and the power of the resurrection. And he said this. He says, when he got rid of that flesh, I was not conscious of any earthly realm. Mm-hmm. You see, but I was only conscious of me. That is, his very essence, which are the attributes. But there was nothing fleshly. And it's been brought out. He said he felt the vibration, or he felt these attributes of intelligence, wisdom, and knowledge, beauty, love, and justice, foundation, power, and strength. Do what? Treading on his body. Was it the flesh? Listen, it was all within his consciousness. And we're trying to get you to see that the purpose and plan of Yahweh is complete. And at the end of the day, it is over. Only thing you're trying to do is get in line with the purpose and to just be. That's all you have to do is just be. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We ought to truly thank the Father for allowing us to hold class this morning, and we hold classes every Tuesday and Friday from 7:30 to 9:30, Sunday mornings from 11 to 1. And the last Sunday of every month, we have a Spanish class from 9:30 to 10:45. So all donations will be accepted by our treasurer, Dr. Irene Ramirez. And I have a few announcements. And if you want a copy of today's lecture, please see Secretary Dr. Kenaway Kleinsman.
Also, I have a little announcement that people said that they can't always hear. So if you're in class and ask a question, be sure to use a microphone because people on the phone can't hear otherwise.
Okay. All righty.
Otherwise, the speaker can also repeat the question
as
well.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. I have a first announcement is the IDMR Pomona presents a recital or original gospel song written, arranged, and produced at Hot Tracks Promotions performed by IDMR of Pomona Hallelujah Choir Saturday, December the 19th. 2015, singing is from 5 to 6 p.m., mingling and catered food from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Donations for guests are $10, and that is held in Upland at 1848 East 11th Street, Suite F. And also, December the 20th starts our winter series, and I will be giving the first lecture on Christmas and the birth of the Messiah. So anybody that wants to give a lecture, thank God you don't have time to get on the floor, here's your chance on Sunday to come up, because Joe got about 36 lectures.
43
lectures you can pick up.
Okay.
So any lecture you want to, any topic that he has here, you can go with it.
And they're very simple, simple stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The universal revelation of Yahshua, that's not simple, but... the Aaronite priesthood, the birth of Yahshua Messiah, baptism, circumcision, the Abrahamic promise, the history plate, Numbers plate 26, cosmogony by the pattern, eschatology by the pattern. This is stuff we talk about all the time, just have a nice little ring to it. The Adamic transgression, the satanic spirit, grafting in the Gentiles, what is the Holy Spirit, the carnal ordinances, restored, simple stuff. Human government, you know, Nebuchadnezzar's dream, Dr. Kinley vision, H.E. Kinley, the seventh angel. Everybody know Will's going to get that lecture. John vision confirming Moses. Yahshua, the Passover Supper. Simple stuff. The angelic transgression, Lucifer in the garden. Yahshua, fulfilled Elohim. It's just simple stuff. You know. Yeah, the seven feast days. You see, Dr. Samuel can give that one. Man by the pattern. You see, the vision. And the revelation, you know, just simple stuff. It's really simple stuff, and I think I got there so many. But I'm gonna sit down. And another thing, is there life after death? Theosophy, which is plate number 3. The tabernacle pattern is simple. The origin of mankind, the day of Pentecost, the soul of mankind. Let's see, what is that? The carnal mind formed in you. It's just stuff we talked about today. 2520, 490 cycle. And the birth of Enoch, plate number 17. So it's little simple stuff like that. But, and if something you don't want to do on this, pick something.
Pick something.
You see? Yeah. Anyway, so that's basically what that is.
And remember, you don't have to take up the full time, because if you don't, somebody will be able to come behind you and help you out. Okay? And also, if you have, let me see if I get this right, if you have a PayPal account, you can go to idmrontario@gmail.com and make a donation. So come back again and study with us. Bring your friends and all your enemies and stand for the doxology. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory, majesty, dominion, and power both before all time, now and ever. Let us all say, Hallelujah.
Come on, bro.
I got a meeting to get to, so I'm rushing out.
We'll see you. You're going to do at least three or four.